In this video, we are going to see the procedure to draw Bode plot. So already we discussed the introduction of Bode plot, which is the combination of magnitude plot and phase plot. So in both that magnitude and phase plot, the x-axis is similar, that is nothing but angular frequency. The y-axis, only the difference between those two plots, the y-axis of magnitude plot will be the 3 dB magnitude, that means m in dB decibels. So here, how we can calculate that magnitude in dB means 20 log modulus of g of j omega into h of j omega. Like that, the y axis for phase plot will be phi is equivalent to angle of open loop transfer function. So now if you see, the main steps that we need to follow when we want to draw Bode plot for any open loop transfer function means, first of all, replace s in the transfer function by j omega to convert total open loop transfer function, OLT means open loop transfer function, into frequency domain. For example, if they given open loop transfer function in S domain, the first step we need to follow is we need to convert that open loop transfer function into frequency domain. How we can convert S domain to frequency domain means, just by substituting S is equivalent to j omega, then we are going to get that frequency domain. Now, after getting frequency domain of our open loop transfer function, so calculate magnitude in dB. How we can calculate magnitude in dB means, so the formula to calculate magnitude in dB is 20 log modulus of g of j omega into h of j omega. So generally we are going to consider unity feedback systems. So this h of j omega will be equivalent to 1, then we are going to consider 20 log modulus of g omega. This will be the formula. So always the base of this log is 10. So now find phase angle phi. The next step is to calculate the phase angle. The formula to calculate phase angle phi, that means which is nothing but y axis of phase plot, is tan inverse imaginary part by real part. So which imaginary part and which real part means, whatever open loop transfer function is there, in that open loop transfer function you need to consider the imaginary parts and real parts, and you need to consider in this formula, and you are going to get particular angle for this phi. So that phi you need to consider, and after that vary the omega from minimum to maximum. After varying omega from minimum to maximum to find m and phi, you are going to get magnitude and phase plot. So you are going to calculate m in dB, and after that phi. Phi means tan inverse imaginary part by real part. So with varying omega, we are going to calculate that m and phi, and we are noting that in a graph. So then we are going to get magnitude and phase plots of our Bode plot. For example, in this video, we already completed a list of basic Bode plots. In that, I given k, constant k, as our first Bode plot. So that also we are going to cover in this video only. So here, constant k means they given open loop transfer function. I am considering example. So here I am considering example of constant k. So here, what is constant k means? This is the meaning, the open loop transfer function is equivalent to k. So for example, if they given g of s is equivalent to k. If they given g of s is equivalent to k, then how will be the structure of Bode plot? So now g of s is equivalent to k means, so if you observe this, first step we need to do is, we need to convert this open loop transfer function into frequency domain. How we can convert? Just by substituting s is equivalent to j omega. So we can convert this open loop transfer function into frequency domain. So here I am considering s is equivalent to j omega. This side there is no s terms to substitute j omega. So g of j omega also equivalent to k. In other cases, for other terms, if you substituted j omega, whatever the s terms are there, that S terms are going to modify. So now G of J omega is equivalent to K. So now here, now I'm going to calculate, I'm going to concentrate on magnitude plot. Magnitude plot means we need magnitude first of all. So magnitude in dB, m in dB is equivalent to 20 log G of J omega. H of J omega is always equivalent to 1, 20 log G of J omega. So here my G of J omega is equivalent to K. I am substituting that 20 log base 10. Always for this magnitude calculation, the log base is 10. And here modulus of G of J omega is nothing but modulus of K. So now if you see this, depending upon the K value, the magnitude is going to vary. For example, this is omega. This is omega. X axis is always similar. This is omega. So this is magnitude in dB. For example, K is equivalent to 1. K is equivalent to 1. What will happen when K is equivalent to 1 means, so this log 1 will be equivalent to 0. So then when K is equivalent to 1, so you are getting like this. For example, K is greater than 1. You will get positive magnitude. That means if K is equivalent to 1, to that means not greater than 1. If K is greater than 1 means 2, 3, 4, 5 like that, then you are getting positive values. If K is less than 1, K is less than 1 means, for example, if you are given with K value like minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 like that, or not minus, or if you consider 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4 also equivalent to less than 1 case. That means less than K case. That means K less than 1. So 0.5 also less than 1 case. Minus 5 also less than 1 case. In all those cases, you are getting negative magnitude. You can check. For example, you just consider K is equivalent to minus 2 and you can consider calculation, you are going to get negative magnitude. If you consider K greater than 1 values, you are going to get all positive magnitude values. So here, if K is greater than 1, you are getting positive magnitude when K greater than 1. When K less than 1, so you are getting negative magnitude. So this is your magnitude plot. This is your magnitude plot of constant K. Now coming to phase plot. So here phase plot means you need to calculate the phase angle. Phi is equivalent to tan inverse imaginary part by real part. So here we are not having any imaginary part. So you are getting tan inverse 0. Tan inverse 0 means it's equivalent to 0. Your phi is equivalent to 0. So here I am considering tan inverse 0 by, so real part is K. Phi is equivalent to tan inverse 0 by K. When you are getting tan inverse 0 means when phi is equivalent to 0, you are getting 0, tan inverse 0 by K. So now here the phase plot is, so omega, and if you consider phi, so here the phase plot phi is equivalent to 0. You are not having any plot here. Your phi is equivalent to 0. Your phase of constant term always will be equivalent to 0. By combining these two plots, you are going to get Bode plot. For example, how we can apply these plots for gate like technical exams means, if they are asking what is the Bode plot for open loop transfer function equivalent to 2, G of S is equivalent to 2, If they are asking like that, then so definitely 2 is a positive value. 2 is greater than 1 value. So we won't get this line. So above omega axis, that means in positive magnitude axis, you will get a line, and in phase plot. So generally your Bode plot will be combination of, for example, k is equivalent to 2. So k equivalent to 2 will be like this. So this is m, this is magnitude plot up to here, and coming to phase plot. So here also we are going to consider omega, and this is phase plot. So this is total Bode plot for k is equivalent to 2. For example, if they given k is equivalent to minus 2, then this line will come here. So like that, we need to trace the Bode plot for constant. So always the Bode plot for constant is differs with magnitude plot. If k value is greater than 1, if the constant values are greater than 1, then you will get the line above omega axis. If k is less than 1, then you will get negative magnitude. So that means you will get line below omega axis. This is about procedure to calculate Bode plot and Bode plot for constant